Good day everyone, I'm RJ D. Molina together with my partner Jerry Carpio and we will be presenting our study entitled 3D Modeling and Topographic Mapping of Creeks through Mobile Phone Based Close Range Photogrammetry, and here's the outline of our presentation. For the background, nowadays creation of realistic 3D scene and topographic mapping of a particular object is now and being more popular, and they are now part of modern age where we can see numerous applications, usually in engineering researches. Specifically, topographic mapping of rivers and creeks, including 3D modeling, are important because it can represent the three-dimensional landscape in two dimensions, and it can be used to extract key sets of topographic information and provide precise data on shape, size, and position. And it also evaluates the actual condition of particular site. And there are some approaches usually used in implementing topographic surveys, and commonly used methods are the use of total station, real-time kinematic by using GNSS, etc. And these approaches are often difficult to implement because it requires more manpower to execute the data collection of the site, and it is also time-consuming. And some alternative of for these approaches is use of the use of photogrammetric-based method, like using LiDAR equipment. But these methods is expensive to use. And also another approach is unmanned aerial system method, where it is also expensive. And another disadvantage of using UAS-based method for topographic mapping is that the terrain or ground below canopies cannot be captured. And another method is using close-range photogrammetry approach. And in using this approach for topographic application, it requires expensive calibrated camera or those metric camera for image acquisition. And for this statement of the problem, topographic mapping of rivers and creeks are important for extracting spatial information, and usual photogrammetric based approach need to have a high expensive camera or metric cameras. And through the use of close range photogrammetry, the camera that can be found in a phone will be used as an alternative in using such expensive camera. And this is where the study comes in, where it aims to evaluate the applicability of mobile phone based close range photogrammetry for 3D modeling and topographic mapping of creeks. And specifically aims to generate the 3D model of creeks through mobile phone based close range photogrammetry, assess the accuracy of the 3D model, and to extract sets of topographic information from the 3D model. And for the significance of the study, it can be an alternative to land surveys, particularly in topographic survey, which is time-consuming and expensive in terms of land survey methodology. And it also can be used to extract topographic characteristics of rivers and creeks.
Hello, I am Jerick D. Carpio, and I'm going to discuss the methodology of our study. So, in Figure 1, the general methodology flowchart. Study area. So, this was conducted on Caracas State University, main campus, but one city. It was implemented on two sites, the canal and the creek. So the canal has less obstruction and have a simple topography, while the creek has several obstructions and complicated topography. Next, we conduct reconnaissance. So conducting reconnaissance determines the possible position of the exposure station. It also determines the potential obstruction and sources of interference during field survey, especially in conducting GNSS survey. So conducting reconnaissance also to determine the position of the ground control points on the site. Image acquisition planning results. Using the camera parameters and the dimension of the site, we then determine the approximate value of the exposure station interval, the number of images per lines, the number of flat lines, and the total images. Next, ground control points establishment. So the ground control points was made out of plywood and painted with black and white with a number on the upper right to easily determine it on the images. So the ground control point dimension was 10 inches by 10 inches and attached to the site using hammer and nails. So the purpose of the ground control points is to accurately position the 3D model in relation to the real world and also determines the accuracy of the 3D model. So in conducting field survey, the GNSS instrument was used. So the brand of the GNSS instrument was South Galaxy J1. So the real-time kinematic or RTK GNSS technique was applied by having a 1-minute interval of each points. So the purpose of field survey was to collect ground coordinates of the ground control points and the profile points and cross-section points. Next, image acquisition. So the smartphone camera was used to acquire an images. So the brand of the smartphone was Xiaomi Redmi Note 8 Pro. So the standard camera was used, having a focal length of 5.43mm and a resolution dimension of 90x48x6936. So during image acquisition, the smartphone camera was attached to the tripod to stabilize the camera, and the timer on the camera was enabled to have a good quality images. The GPS on the smartphone camera was also enabled to be used for georeferencing. So image processing. So the structured from motion and multi-view stereo matching was applied. throughout the generation of the 3D model. On structure promotion, it was associated with scale invariant feature transform and bundle block adjustment. So in terms of software use, Agisoft Metashape was used to process the images and generate the images into a 3D model. So sparse point cloud generation. So we conduct georeferencing using the ground control points to position the 3D model in relation to the real world. So scale invariant feature transform was used to match the features on the images. Then bundle block adjustments was used to calculate the camera positions, the camera orientations, and position of the corresponding features or the corresponding tie points. So in generating dense point cloud, it was associated with multi-view stereo matching. So the multi-view stereo matching produced a dense point cloud using parameters on the camera that was determined using the bundle block adjustments and the tie points using the scale invariant feature transform. So the dense model has the same resolution as the pictures since all pixels and images are incorporated. Next, interpolation process was applied in generating the DEM. So the interpolation process is a technique of generating a surface using data at isolated sample locations. So after generating the DEM, the orthomosaic was then generated. So the orthomosaic is geometrically accurate images produced by stitching together. Next, so the checkpoint was used in determining the accuracy of the 3D model. So on the canal, 4 GCP was used for the checkpoints. On the click, 5 GCP was used to be the checkpoints. So applying the formula of the spatial accuracy determination and mean absolute error to determine the error of the 3D model and determine the accuracy. So the purpose of data integration was to interpret and analyze the 3D model. So in conducting data integration, we compare the two results from the 3D model and the data from the field survey.
And for the results, here is the images gathered of the test canal having a total of 254 images captured. From the images gathered, with the use of specialized software, we generated sparse point cloud and dense point cloud of the test canal, which can be used to generate the orthomosaic and digital elevation model of the test canal. And here's the generated orthomosaic and digital terrain model of the test canal, where the red color indicates the highest elevation and the blue indicates the lowest elevation of the test canal. And using the checkpoints of the canal, we computed the accuracy of canal having a horizontal accuracy of 0.01 at 95 meter at 95% confidence level and a vertical accuracy of 0.0029 meter at 95% accuracy level. And the generated DEM of the canal has a spatial resolution of 1.6 millimeter per pixel. Here is the location of the profile points of the test canal during the on-site survey. And the result of the cross-section profile comparing the difference elevation of field survey and 3D model, where the blue line indicates the elevation of the field survey and the orange line indicates the elevation of extracted elevation in the 3D model. And also the difference in elevation of center line of the test canal showing its vertical error and vertical accuracy. And for the result of the actual study area, this is the sample images gathered out of 234 images on Creek. And the generated sparse point cloud and dense point cloud of the creek. For the digital terrain model of the creek showing the highest elevation and the lowest elevation. The generated DEM of the creek has a spatial resolution of 5.54 millimeter per pixel and having a horizontal and vertical accuracy of 0.35 meter and 0.6380 meters respectively at 95% confidence level. Here is the location of the profile points of the creek during the field survey for data integration. And here's the result for the cross-section profile of the creek showing the difference elevation of field survey and extracted elevation of 3D model. And also for the difference elevation of center line of the creek. For the conclusion, the approach of mobile phone-based close-range photogrammetry is cost-effective, efficient to generate 3D model of creeks and extract cross-section profile. The canal can achieve a horizontal and a vertical accuracy of 0.01 meter and 0.0029 meters, respectively, at 95% confidence level. And for the creek, this method can achieve a horizontal and vertical accuracy of 0.350 meter and 0.639 meters, respectively, at 95% confidence level. For the recommendation, based on the discussion experiments, consider more flexibility regarding to the camera angle and heights to make more efficient and covering the other parts of the area. And the unwanted background of trees and sky should be also minimal in image acquisition to avoid overexposure that will negatively affect the quality and the reconstruction during the process. And if possible, use tripod to ensure steady images and avoid blurred region of images due to movements, and use other surveying instruments in obtaining coordinates of GCP on the canopy areas in case of signal problems. And that ends our presentation. And thank you for your listening.